Hello everyone. Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept that is EBITDA margin. EBITDA is one of the important driver which is used in valuation purpose, that is EV by EBITDA ratio. This is one of the most important ratio which is which investors, stakeholders, investment bankers, they use to analyze the company. EV by EBITDA is one really big ratio. So we need to understand what is EBITDA margin. Now we have this graph over here, but before that, let's understand first what is EBITDA margin and then come back to this graph. See, EBITDA margin is basically profitability ratio. Okay, this is a profitability ratio that calculates that how much EBITDA, that is earning before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization, is generated as a percentage of sales. Okay, so this is basically the interpretation part of what exactly is your EBITDA margin. Now, EBITDA is found after deducting the operating expenses like cost of goods sold, that is a COGS, general and admin cost, etc. from the total sales. See, you need to know that it should exclude any sort of depreciation and amortization. And from here, we note that from the graph of the EBITDA margin of Facebook, Apple and Google, Facebook margin is currently around 52% and has been consistently higher than Apple and Google's margin. This implies that 48% of the revenue is your operating expenses over here in this particular scenario. Apple's margin has been in around 30 to 35%, so rest has to be the operating profit or operating expenses. And in case of Google, Google margin has been in the range of 30 to 32%. Close enough to that, there was a sharp decline over here. Well, historically, however, in its most recent quarter, it reported a lower EBITDA margin of 19.46. So what exactly, how do they calculate this EBITDA margin? See, EBITDA is equal to your operating income plus any depreciation plus any amortization. So to calculate the EBITDA ratio, you can use the above formula, okay? And we'll drill down on the term EBITDA margin in the following components. The EBI, okay, over here is equal to your earning before your interest expense, okay? So this is going to be your EBI. Then your T is your taxes. Then the next is D, which is your depreciation, and A is your amortization. Now, EBITDA margin calculation of one company. Let's see the EBITDA margin calculation of Starbucks. So this is on the screen. If you can see, this is the screenshot of the income statement and the snapshot of Starbucks Corp. And we note that the earning before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization is not directly provided in the income statement. See the net revenue, depreciation and operating income. So it's not directly provided over here. So how we are supposed to do this? See, in 2017, if you see, this is the 2017 case I'm talking about. The EBITDA for 2017 is going to be your 4134.7. You need to add back any depreciation and amortization, which is 1011.4. So that will give you 5146.1 million. And your EBITDA margin formula is going to be your EBITDA, that is 5146.1. divide by your sales, which is 22,386. So let's try and evaluate this. It's 5146. It is equal to 5146.1 million. And our net sales is 22,386. So let's just divide EBITDA divided by net sales. We receive 23%, 22.98 for 2017. In the similar fashion, we can look for 2016's data. The EBITDA for 2016 is 4171. This was for 2017. This is for 2016. So we'll add things as 4171.9.9 plus we need to add the depreciation and amortization 980.9. So we'll get our EBITDA as 5152 and our net sales is 319.5. So we just don't need to calculate. Control R when received 24%. And for 2015, let's calculate the same 3601 plus we need to add 893.9 as your amortization, and let's take the sales figure as 19162. Just copy down the formula, we get 23. So 23 to 24, again back to 23%. So in this fashion, we have calculated till 2015 all the margins, right? For this is basically the Starbucks Corp consolidated statement of earnings. Got it. So I hope you have got a real idea about how the formula is calculated from a real life example that we evaluated and not something that was hypothetical. Now let's understand why EBITDA margin is important. See, considered first, it is considered to be the cash operating profit margin. This is the first and the foremost reason behind this. See, it is basically, you can say, a cash operating margin that does not include the effect of any capital structure base as well as any non-cash item, you can say. So, like depreciation and amortization. Second, it provides us with the measure of how much the cash of the company is generating per unit of revenue. You know, however, the cash flow from the operations per unit revenue can be more precise in this context. Second, you need to remove something from here is the non-operating effects, if any. So the EBITDA margin calculation basically removes any non-operating effects that are unique to each other, to each company. Like, for example, if you compare companies in the oil and the gas sector, each company may follow a different depreciation and amortization policies, like SLM and we have WDV and so on and so forth. Now the third important thing, EBITDA removes all these non-operative effects and also helps to make a company comparison much better for two companies. Fourth, it is also useful for a year over year comparison Y to Y comparison, that is your year to year comparison analysis. Now what exactly are the drawbacks for this particular case? See, first and the foremost thing, Window dressing is very much possible. See, comparison companies with low profit margin may try to window dress their margin figures by highlighting the EBITDA margin instead of the net profit margin. Second, EBITDA is basically a non-GAAP measure. Okay, since EBITDA is a non-GAAP measure and is not regulated, some companies may use it to portray a rosy financial statement or situation of a company. And it can be incorrectly applied. Okay, this is one bad thing. It can be incorrectly applied. The margin should not be used to compare the companies with a high debt capitalization, as their interest expense will be very high, and EBITDA margins will not capture the amount of the debt. So, and also, if you compare the two companies, one with a low debt capitalization and other one with high debt capitalization, the finding may not lead to the correct conclusion. Now this is the list I'm showing you of oil and gas company. This is a list of the top companies in the oil and gas sector along with their margins and market capitalization, the EBITDA margin, the market cap. So over here we note that the margin of these oil and gas companies is generally higher in the range of 25 to 30%, as you can see. And the Transocean has the negative margin. It's making tremendous amount of losses, and Rowan companies is basically making the highest amount of the profit, is the best in the lot with the margin of 41.6.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.